morning students, welcome to chemistry online class. Today we will discuss about unit 2 p block elements 1. Topics are boric acid formula H3BO3, boric acid formula H3BO3 or BOH thrice. Another one topic is alums. Potash alum. Example is a potash alum. Different kinds of alums are here. The first one, example, potash alum. Potash alum formula K2SO4 dot Al2SO4 thrice dot 24H2O. The first one, boric acid. The first one is a boric acid. Boric acid. First, boric acid. Boric acid formula H3BO3 or BOH3. The first preparation of boric acid. Boric acid can be extracted from borax and colmanite. Already theriyum namakku colmanite formula Ca2B6O11. Boric acid can be extracted from borax. Borax formula Na2B4O7. And colmanite. Colmanite formula Ca2B6O11. So boric acid can be extracted from borax and colmanite. So equations are Na2B4O7. That is a borax. Plus H2SO4. Sulfuric acid. 5 moles of water. 5 moles of water. Borax, sulfuric acid, water to give 4 moles of boric acid H3BO3 and sodium sulfate Na2SO4. Borax react with the sulfuric acid and water to give boric acid. Byproduct here, sodium sulfate. Next, colmanite. Colmanite formula Ca2B6O11. Ca2B6O11. Then treated with 11 moles of sulfuric acid. 11 moles of sulfuric acid and 4 moles of sulfur dioxide. And 4 moles of sulfur dioxide. It gives 6 moles of H3BO3, boric acid. 6 moles of H3BO3 and byproduct 2 moles of HSO3 twice. Calcium bisulfite. Byproduct is a calcium bisulfite. Boric acid can be extracted from borax and colmanite. Borax Na2B4O7, colmanite Ca2B6O11. Borax react with the sulfuric acid H2SO4 plus 5 moles of water molecule to give 4 moles of boric acid and sodium sulfate. Colmanite then treated with 11 moles of sulfuric acid and 4 moles of sulfur dioxide. It gives 6 moles of boric acid and 2 moles of calcium bisulfite. Next, properties of boric acid. Properties of boric acid. Boric acid is a colorless, transparent crystal. Boric acid is a colorless, transparent crystal. It is a very weak monobasic acid. It is a very weak monobasic acid. Mono means one. That is the one hydrogen, that means H plus is a donator. There is a one proton is a donator. So it is a very weak monobasic acid. It accepts a hydroxyl ion rather than donating proton. Boric acid is a colorless transparent crystal. It is a very weak monobasic acid. It accepts hydroxyl ion rather than donating proton. So boric acid H3BO3 or BOH3 times plus 2H2. So boric acid first na minus seiyum appadina boric acid structure paakala adu romba important B OH another one so next okay that is a boric acid one borane three numbers OH hydroxide group is a percent so boric acid structure 3 OH OH okay so next boric acid is a weak monobasic acid and it accept hydroxyl ion and it accept hydroxyl ion rather than donating proton so here 2 moles of water 2 moles of water HOH it is H plus OH minus another one is H plus OH minus in this one OH that is hydroxyl ion is accepting this boron that is electron deficient phases okay so it is converted into B OH 4 times plus in this hydroxyl ion that is H3O plus is produced H3O plus so here B OH 4 times a minus H3O plus okay so boric acid basically having 3 moles of OH group that is a hydroxyl group so next one is it reacts with the sodium hydroxide to form sodium metaborate and sodium tetraborate sodium hydroxide boric acid react with sodium hydroxide to give sodium metaborate and sodium tetraborate first sodium hydroxide react with the boric acid it gives NaBO2 sodium metaborate plus 2H2O sodium metaborate is produced next 2 moles of sodium hydroxide 2 moles of sodium hydroxide 4 moles of boric acid is reacted 2 moles the number of moles are increased here okay the first equation just one mole both sodium hydroxide and boric acid it gives a sodium metaborate but 2 moles of sodium hydroxide react with the 4 moles of boric acid it gives a Na2B4O7 sodium tetraborate otherwise called a borax one mole of sodium hydroxide react with the 1 mole of boric acid we get sodium metaborate 2 moles of sodium hydroxide react with the 4 moles of boric acid it gives sodium tetraborate that is a borax another one is a action of heat boric acid when heated at 373 kelvin first temperature is a 373 kelvin it gives a metaboric acid HBO2 metaboric acid boric acid when heated at 373 kelvin it gives a metaboric acid and at 413 kelvin it gives a tetraboric acid H2B4O7 tetraboric acid when heated at a red hot condition it gives anhydride which is a glassy mass that is a boron trioxide B2O3 action of heat boric acid when heated at 373 kelvin boric acid heated at 373 kelvin gives a metaboric acid formula HBO2 so here hydrogen 4 into 3 12 4 hydrogen 4 into 2 8. 8 plus 4, 12. Okay, equation is a balanced. Next, metaboric acid. When heated at the 413 Kelvin, to give a tetraboric acid. Tetraboric acid formula H2B4O7. So 4 hydrogen, 2 plus 2, 4 hydrogen equation balance. Tetraboric acid, when heated at a red hot condition, it is a red hot condition, to give anhydride, which is a glassy mass. Anhydride means that particular substance does not having water molecules. So to give anhydrous glassy mass substance, that is a B2O3, boron trioxide. The next one is a action of ammonia. Ammonia formula NH3. Okay. Fusion of urea. Urea formula NH2CONH2. That is a urea formula. Fusion of urea with boric acid. With boric acid in an atmosphere of ammonia at 800 to 1200 Kelvin. It gives a boron nitride. Okay, boric acid. Boric acid formula H3BO3. React with ammonia. Ammonia formula NH3. It gives a boron nitride and water. So boric acid react with ammonia. It gives a boron nitride and water. This is the action of ammonia. Fusion of urea with the boric acid. Urea formula NH2CONH2. In an atmosphere of ammonia at 800 to 1200 Kelvin, gives a boron nitride. The next one is a borate test. It is an important one. Okay, borate test. Okay, when boric acid or borate salt, borate salt is here Ca3BO3 twice. Ca3 calcium borate, that is a calcium borate. Ca3BO3 twice, that is a calcium borate. When boric acid, that is a H3BO3 or BOH twice, or borate salt, that is an example calcium borate, is a heated with ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol formula CH2OH or C2H5OH. Ethyl alcohol is a heated with ethyl alcohol. In presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, H2SO4, an ester, trialkyl borate is formed. The vapor of this ester burns with a green-edged flame. That is apple green color, green-edged flame. And this reaction is used to identify the presence of borate. That is a borate test. எதுக்கு நமக்கு யூஸ் ஆகுது அப்படினா presence of organic substance and inorganic substance நம்ம கொடுத்திருக்கிறதுல borate இருக்குறத நம்ம வந்து கண்டுபிடிக்கிறதுக்கு borate test. திருப்பியும் பாப்போம். When boric acid or borate salt, boric acid H3BO3 or BOH twice, or borate salt, calcium borate, Ca3BO3 twice, that is a calcium borate, is a heated with ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol formula CH3CH2OH or C2H5OH. In a presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, an ester, trialkyl borate is formed. The vapor of this A star burns with a green edged flame and this reaction is used to identify the presence of a borate. Borate test equation is H3BO3, that is a boric acid. React with 3 moles of ethyl alcohol, C2H5OH. It gives a triethyl borate. It gives what a triethyl borate? BOC2H5 3 times. Plus 3H2O. Boric acid react with ethyl alcohol. It gives triethyl borate. So, BOH. So, boric acid formula H3BO3 or enna solluva nama BOH thrice. That is the simplest form. Then treated with 3 moles of ethyl alcohol. 3 moles of ethyl alcohol. Ipdi eduvom nama vasathikaga. C2H5, HOC2H5, HOC2H5. Just OH. So 3 moles of water. HOH, 3 moles of water. Balance B. B. OC2H5 3 times. So B. OC2H5 3 times. That is a triethyl borate. This is the formation. Okay, next. Very, very important note here. The trialkyl borate on reaction with the sodium hydride. Sodium hydride formula NaH. Sodium hydride formula NaH. In a tetrahydrofuran, there is a tetrahydrofuran is a THF. Tetrahydrofuran THF. To form a coordination compound. Coordination compound otherwise called a complex. In the coordination compound, NA, BH, NA, BH, OR 3 times. The trialkyl borate on reaction with the sodium hydride, NaH, in tetrahydrofuran to form a coordination compound, especially that is NaBHOR 3 times, which acts as a powerful reducing agent. The next formation of borane trifluoride. Borane trifluoride formula BF3. Boric acid reacts with the calcium fluoride. CaF2. Calcium fluoride formula CaF2. In presence of concentrated sulfuric acid and gives a BF3. That is a borane trifluoride. 3 moles of calcium fluoride. The same. 3 moles of sulfuric acid. And 2 moles of boric acid. 3 moles of calcium fluoride. 3 moles of sulfuric acid. 2 moles of boric acid. It gives 2 moles of borane trifluoride. That is the main product. Okay. Boric acid reacts with the calcium fluoride in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid to give BF3, that is a borane trifluoride. Next byproduct is 3 moles of calcium sulfate plus and 6 moles of H2O. Okay, the next one is boric acid when heated with soda ash. Soda ash means here sodium carbonate. Boric acid when heated with soda ash, it gives borax. Soda ash, that is a sodium carbonate, Na2CO3, then react with 4 moles of boric acid. It gives Na2B4O7. That is a borax. Plus carbon dioxide. is 6 moles of H2O. 6 moles of H2O. Boric acid, when heated with the soda, add sodium carbonate. It gives borax. Borax formula Na2B4O7. Next, uses of boric acid. Uses of boric acid. The first one, boric acid is used in the manufacture of pottery glass, enamels and pigments. It is used as an antiseptic and as an eye lotion. It is used as an antiseptic and as eye lotion. It is also used as a food preservatives. Again, one more time, boric acid is used in the manufacture of pottery glass, enamels and pigments. It is used as an antiseptic and as an eye lotion. Last one, it is also used as a food preservatives. Okay, next topic here, alums. Next topic, alums. The name alum is given to the double salt. It is a simple salt, double salt. So double salt, two salts are combined together. Simple salt example, NaCl, KCl, just like. But here, double salt of potassium and aluminium sulfate. Potassium and the aluminium sulfate. On example, K2SO4, Al2SO4 twice. That is potassium sulfate, aluminium sulfate, that 24H2, that is a crystalline water. So that is a potash alum. The name alum is given to the double salt of potassium and aluminium sulfate, so K2SO4, Al2SO4 twice, that 24H2O. Nowadays, it is used for all double salts with the M single dash, that is M2 single dash SO4. Next one is M2 double dash SO4. SO4 twice. M2 single dash SO4. M2 double dash SO4 twice. Dot 24H2O. Nowadays it is used for all double salts. M2 single dash SO4, M2 double dash SO4, dot 24H2O, where M single dash is univalent. Uni means mono, one. Univalent ion. Univalent metal ion. M double dash. Univalent metal ion are NH4 plus. So, idhiyum sollalam. And M double dash is a trivalent. Tri means a 3. Trivalent metal ion. Trivalent metal ion. Okay, example Al3 plus, just like. So, overall example, the first one, potash alum. Potash alum formula K2SO4. Al2SO4 thrice, dot 24H2O, that is potash alum. The next one is a sodium alum. Sodium alum formula Na2SO4. Al2SO4 thrice, dot 24H2O. 24H2. So that is a sodium alum. Potash alum K2SO4 dot Al2SO4 thrice dot 24H2. Sodium alum Na2SO4 Al2SO4 thrice dot 24H2. Next, ammonium alum. NH4, twice SO4, ammonium atom, NH4 twice SO4, Al2 SO4 trisa dot 24 H2O. Next chrome atom. Next chrome atom, K2SO4. There is a different. Okay. Dot Cr2SO4 trisa. So inga da the change over. Charingla. So K2SO4 dot Cr2SO4 trisa dot 24 H2O. Potash alum K2SO4 dot Al2SO4 thrice 24 H2O. Sodium alum Na2SO4 Al2SO4 thrice 24 H2O. Ammonium alum NH4 twice SO4 Al2SO4 thrice 24 H2O. But chrome alum K2SO4 Cr2SO4 thrice dot 24 H2O. Alums in general are more soluble in hot water than in cold water under in solutions. They exhibit the properties of constituent ions. Example, book la irukadhu, or example mattum na kudukuren. Potash alum K2SO4 dot Al2SO4 thrice dot 24 H2O. Alums in general are more soluble in hot water than in cold water and in solutions. They exhibit the properties of constituent ion. Avanga avanudaiya solution irukkumbodhu respective ions kudukum. That is a double salt or important property. Simple salt also. Okay. So 2K plus 2Al 3 plus 4SO4 2 minus plus 24 H2O. Potash alum then dissolved in water to give a respective ions or constituent ions. Okay, water lirukum bolda kurukum. Onodia respective ions kurukum. Potassium 2 plus 2 potassium, so 2K plus. 2Al, 2Al 3 plus. SO4, 3SO4, so 1 plus 3, 4, 4SO4, 2 minus. That is a negative ion. So 24H2O. Next, preparation. Preparation. The alunite or alum stone, alunite or alum stone, is the naturally occurring form and it is K2SO4, alum stone formula. K2SO4 Al2SO4 thrice and 4AlOH thrice. 4AlOH thrice. That is alum stone or alunite. When alum stone is treated with excess of sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid formula H2SO4. The AlOH thrice part, that is aluminium hydroxide part, is converted into aluminium sulfate, Al2SO4. So, in the hydrogen, OH koda sendu water convert aayidu. So, ingirikra sulfate aluminium koda chendu. Okay. When alum stone is treated with excess of sulfuric acid, the AlOH thrice, that is aluminium hydroxide, is converted into aluminium sulfate. A calculated quantity, that is an important word. Okay, va? Book cleaning on the underline panikonga. A calculated quantity, that is kanakida patta alavu, of a potassium sulfate is added. Yana yavunudiya concentration or composition is raised. Okay, va? Yava adhigam aayidu. Adhala enna pannano, or kanakida patta alavuku potassium sulfate nam add panikonga. A calculated quantity of potassium sulfate is added and the solution is crystallized. To generate potash alum, it is purified by recrystallization. The alunite or alum stone is the naturally occurring form iron stone alunite K2SO4 Al2SO4 thrice dark 4 Al OH thrice. That is a potassium sulfate, aluminium sulfate, aluminium hydroxide. When iron stone is treated with excess of sulfuric acid, the AlOH thrice, that is aluminium hydroxide, hydroxide part is converted into sulfate part. A calculated quantity of potassium sulfate, that is the potassium sulfate is a K2SO4, is added and the solution is crystallized to generate the potash alum. It is purified by recrystallization. So equation K2SO4 Al2SO4 thrice 4 Al OH thrice, that is alunite or alum stone, plus 6H2SO4. It gives a K2SO4 plus 3Al2SO4 thrice plus 12H2. So next K2SO4 plus Al2SO4 thrice plus 24H2O. That is a 3 times a thrice. 24H2O. It gives alum. That is a potash alum. K2SO4. Al2SO4 thrice. Dot 24H2O. 24H2O. Next up, properties of alum. Potash alum is a white crystalline solid, soluble in water and insoluble in alcohol. Soluble in water and insoluble in alcohol. The aqueous solution is acidic. Aqueous solution is acidic due to the hydrolysis of aluminium sulfate. It melts at 365 Kelvin on heating. Potash alum is a white crystalline solid. It is a soluble in water and insoluble in alcohol. Alcohol la karayadu, neer la karayum. The aqueous solution is acidic due to the hydrolysis of aluminium sulfate. It melts at 365 Kelvin on heating. At 475 Kelvin, losses water of hydration and swells up. Konja satru parumanaga maarum. 475 Kelvin la irukkira water molecules ella loss pannittu we are get swollen mass. The swollen mass is known as burnt alum. That is an important key point. 475 Kelvin losses water of hydration and swells up. The swollen mass is known as burnt alum. Heating to red hot, it decomposed into potassium sulfate, alumina and sulfur trioxide. The equation is K2SO4 Al2SO4 thrice 24H2O. At 500 Kelvin, K2SO4 dot Al2SO4 thrice plus 24H2O. So next K2SO4, that is a potassium sulfate, aluminium sulfate, condition is a red dot condition. It gives a potassium sulfate K2SO4 Al2O3, that is alumina, aluminium trioxide or alumina, plus 3 moles of sulfur trioxide. Okay. So next, potash alum forms aluminium hydroxide when treated with ammonium hydroxide. Potash alum forms aluminium hydroxide when treated with ammonium hydroxide. Ammonium hydroxide kuda react pannum bodhu பொட்டாஷ் ஆலத்தில் இருக்கக்கூடிய சல்ஃபேட் பார்ட் எல்லாம் கன்வெர்ட் ஆகிடுது. என்னவா அப்படின்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஹைட்ராக்சைட் பார்ட்டாக, ஓகேவா, அலுமினைட் ஃபார்முலாவில் வர மாதிரி அலுமினியம் ஓஹெச் ப்ரைஸ் ஏஎல் ஓஹெச் ப்ரைஸாக மாறும். ஸோ பொட்டாஷ் ஆலம் கே டூ எஸ்ஓ ஃபோர் ஏஎல் டூ எஸ்ஓ ஃபோர் ப்ரைஸா டாட் டுவெண்ட்டி ஃபோர் ஹெச் டூஓ ப்ளஸ் சிக்ஸ் மோல்ஸ் ஆஃப் அமோனியம் ஹைட்ராக்சைட் சிக்ஸ் மோல்ஸ் ஆஃப் அமோனியம் ஹைட்ராக்சைட் அமோனியம் ஹைட்ராக்சைட் ஃபார்ம்னா என்ஹெச் ஃபோர் ஓஹெச் இட் கிவ்ஸ் கே டூ எஸ்ஓ ஃபோர் பொட்டாசியம் சல்ஃபேட் தனியாக வருது. நெக்ஸ்ட் த்ரீ மோல்ஸ் ஆஃப் என்ஹெச் ஃபோர் ட்வைஸ் எஸ்ஓ ஃபோர் தட் இஸ் அமோனியம் சல்ஃபேட் என்ஹெச் ஃபோர் ட்வைஸ் எஸ்ஓ ஃபோர் இஸ் அமோனியம் சல்ஃபேட் ப்ளஸ் டுவெண்ட்டி ஃபோர் ஹெச் டூஓ அண்ட் டூ மோல்ஸ் ஆஃப் அலுமினியம் ஹைட்ராக்சைடு அலுமினியம் ஹைட்ராக்சைடு பொட்டாசியம் ஃபார்ம்ஸ் அலுமினியம் ஹைட்ராக்சைடு when it treated with ammonium hydroxide. Next, uses of alum. Next, uses of alum. Uses of alum. It is used in the purification of water. It is used for purification of water. Dam water, ஏரி வாட்டர் அது மாதிரிலாம் இருக்கிறதுலாம் இருக்கக்கூடியதில் நம்ம தூய்மைப்படுத்துறதுக்கு இருக்கக்கூடிய மைக்ரோ ஆர்கானிசம் எல்லாம் டிஸ்ட்ராய் பண்ணிட்டு போர்ட்டபிள் வாட்டர் தட் இஸ் அ ட்ரிங்கிங் வாட்டரை கன்வெர்ட் பண்ணுறதுல மெயின் ப்ராசஸில் நம்ம இதை யூஸ் பண்ணுறாங்க. ஸோ இட் இஸ் யூஸ்டு ஃபார் பியூரிஃபிகேஷன் ஆஃப் வாட்டர். இட் இஸ் ஆல்சோ யூஸ்டு ஃபார் வாட்டர் ப்ரூஃபிங் அண்ட் டெக்ஸ்டைல்ஸ் ரெயின் கோட் அந்த மாதிரி இருக்கிறதுல நம்ம யூஸ் பண்ணிக்கிறாங்க தயாரிக்கிற இடத்துல. நெக்ஸ்ட் இட் இஸ் யூஸ்ட் இன் டைங் பேப்பர் அண்ட் லெதர் டேர்னிங் இண்டஸ்ட்ரி தோல் பதனிடக்கூடிய தொழிற்சாலைகளில் லெதர் டேர்னிங் இண்டஸ்ட்ரீஸ். நெக்ஸ்ட் லாஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் இட் இஸ் எம்ப்ளாய்டு ஆஸ் அ ஸ்டிப்டிக் ஏஜென்ட் டு அரெஸ்ட் ப்ளீடிங். ஸோ ஆலம் ஸ்டோனை வாட்டரில் டிப் பண்ணி எங்கேயாச்சும் நமக்கு வந்து காயப்பட்டு பிளட் வந்து வெளியில் லாஸ் ஆகிட்டு இருக்கு அப்படின்னா தண்ணியில் டிப் பண்ணி மேலே ஆலம் ஸ்டோனை வச்சு லைட்டாக தேய்ச்சோம்னா இம்மிடியேட்டாக பிளட் வந்து அரெஸ்ட் ஆகும், ப்ளீட் ஆகாமல். இட் இஸ் யூஸ்டு ஃபார் பியூரிஃபிகேஷன் ஆஃப் வாட்டர். It is also used for waterproofing and textiles. It is used in dyeing paper and leather tanning industry. It is employed as a styptic agent to arrest bleeding. Okay, innikku indha rendu topic namakku indha class mudiyudhu. Next class la next topic oda ungala meet pandra. Thank you.